Hey fellow world dwellers, it's Angry Turtle, and in today's video I want to explain everything explosive, everything related to this topic. I will attempt to explain, as after my last video I had so many questions. First I attempted to answer those comments, and after a moment I was like, no, it's not possible. I'm gonna do the video, explain everything, and I will have some kind of a reference point in the future where to send people asking questions about explosions in this game, because this topic is not as simple as you think. First, let's start with some basics, as mostly we are interested in explosive bullets, but not only. I refer to this legendary effect, bullets explode for area damage. What does it do and how does it work? That's the most important part. But then how regular explosive weapons like grenade launchers, broadsiders, stuff like that works as well. Then here we go. First, I have regular pipe rifle and explosive pipe rifle. Nothing is boosting damage of the explosive pipe rifle apart from explosive legendary effect, because it's a junkies and I have zero addictions. Therefore, only explosive legendary effect is boosting the damage. And as you can see in here, regular pipe rifle have 38 damage, explosive one, 45 damage. That's because explosive effect is 20% damage on top on weapon damage, but don't be mistaken, it's not that your weapon will be doing the 45 damage advertised in here. It's not like that, it's just in the weapon card, the explosion is added on top of weapon damage. Therefore, this pipe rifle will still do 38 damage, but there will be additional effect, explosion, that will be doing additional 7 damage. Although, this additional damage will be calculated separately, what means in practice it will be way less than 7 damage. That's a little bit complicated math from Bethesda in here, and I don't know why explosive damage is just added on top, because it's kind of misleading, as your weapon is not doing more damage by itself, but it have additional explosion that deal separate damage, in this case 7 damage. Now you can boost explosive damage by equipping Demolition Expert, and it will add 60% to the damage of the explosion, not the damage of the gun, unless gun is doing 100% explosive damage. If it's not, then it's just boosting the damage of the explosion. Then after we equip it, you can see that damage went up, and explosive damage now, it's not 7, but it's 12. And 12 is way more than 60%, but there are, in small numbers, there are rounding errors, therefore it's okay, it's 60%. If you'll have higher number, it will be easier to spot. It's 60% extra damage. It's still not additive, but multiplicative, what makes calculations way easier, because 60% is 60%, as you would expect it. Then we have now 38 damage from the weapon and 12 damage from the explosion that is attached to the bullet. Apart from that, explosive projectile are overriding the projectiles, changing the speed and animation of the projectile, and this effect is easy to spot when you have a legacy weapon, but we'll go to the legacy weapons in the moment. First, we'll see how this explosive effect works. And if you think it's simple so far, don't worry, it will be way more complicated. And now we have some super mutant, and as I was explaining, first let's shoot one with regular pipe rifle. You can see 26 damage, nothing else, just pure 26 damage. Then I'm taking this explosive gun. Okay, we shoot different super mutant, the result will be very similar. And you can see 27 damage and 7 damage and 6 damage from the explosion. Unfortunately, damage from the explosion is quite low, because it's reduced by super mutant armor separately than the bullet hitting by itself. Then that's why we have 27 and 6, and there is a couple more 6s. Those are damage that are registered, but that. All those sandbags actually register damage when you shoot them. Then it will be probably better to shoot this guy. Now you have just 27 and 6, and again, regular pipe rifle, just 27. Now you see that both pipe rifles have exactly the same main damage, just the explosion is added on top. And if you think it's simple so far, now we will add some complications. If I shoot him in the head, it's 5, you see? The main damage is 54, but explosion only 5. And you would think, why is it going down? It's supposed to go up. And you're right. It's supposed to go up, but because of how explosion is calculated in this game, it's not linear. The problem is explosives have a radius. There's a radius of the explosion. And if you hit him in the head, he cannot take explosive damage into the head. I don't know why, but explosive will be calculated always at his feet when he's standing. Therefore, it's quite far from the head, and explosion is losing damage the farther away you go from the point of the explosion, when the explosion started. Therefore, to get a best out of the explosion, I should be shooting close to his leg to the point when he's standing. If he'll be flying though, I will get like zero damage from the explosion as he's not standing anywhere then. But luckily he's not flying. Then now we try to shoot his feet. And now it's 6. Damage from the explosion went back to normal. Generally, lower you shoot, the more damage explosion can do. Higher you shoot on the enemy, farther from the ground, the less damage it will do. Up to the point, if enemy is really big, that it will do no damage. Then if you'll be shooting like Colossus into the torso or head, explosion will do zero damage. If you shoot his leg, it will do damage again. And now to complicate things a little bit further, we have weapons like two-shot and explosive. Like this, bolt-action rifle, two-shot explosive. What it does, normally two-shot weapon, split projectile on half and add 25% damage in total, bonus damage. In case of two-shot explosive, it still adds 25% bonus damage to the weapon, split the bullet on half, but what are the consequences of that? The explosion is happening twice with full power. What means two-shot explosive is way better if you want to deal damage with the explosions than any other explosive weapon. And now if we shoot this guy, let's shoot him in arm. I don't have scope on that. Okay, let's see. I did it. You were able to see there was couple damage numbers. Maybe leg now. Yeah, 57, 21, something else. 257, 21. It's not easy to spot all those explosions and as though occurring in the one spot. And I'm moving. Yeah, it's hard to notice, but there are two explosions coming with this gun. Let me try to just shoot the ground, maybe. Oh, it's actually taking only one explosive. Oh, now. Now there was two numbers. Yeah, it's not easy, not so easy to trigger them, just keep firing. But I think shooting ground is the most reliable way. Yeah, those are two numbers, usually on top of each other. It's why it's so hard to spot them. Now, we're going for some more complications. Gauss weapons, because last video was about Gauss weapons. I have this Gauss pistol, and the problem in here is that Gauss weapons have smaller explosive radius than normal legendary explosive weapons. They do actually borrow the size of explosion from the Broadsider. I don't know why, but that's the reason I have Broadsider in here. I will show you that. Broadsider is a fully explosive weapon. Gauss pistol, it just has a portion of the explosive damage and follows the rules like any other legendary explosive weapon, apart from the smaller radius of the explosion. And that applies to all Gauss weapons, therefore I will use only this one. I shoot him in his leg. Can you see explosion 15? You can see it on the torso, like impact. You can always see when you actually hit. Whoops. Okay, I'm hidden again. Impact, you can always see where you aim, but the explosion damage always on the torso, like around the middle of the enemy. And where the problem starts, because I shoot the leg and there was explosive damage and there's impact damage, all fine. But where the problem starts, when I shoot his head. Why are they always moving when I try to show something? Look at me. Okay, let's try. And 34, nothing else. There was no second number. Unfortunately, the radius is not big enough to attach to the ground which means there will be no explosive damage, like this explosion never existed. What means in the same time that we are losing advertised damage from the gun, because damage that I have in here, this 143, include a huge portion that's an explosion that's accompanied this gun. Fortunately, I'm not getting anything from this explosion if I hit the head. Next point. Legacy explosive weapons. That's not the end, it only looked like that. I didn't start about the VATS yet. Okay, legacy explosive weapons. And now what's the difference? If I shoot him, you will be able to see all numbers are high. 10980 something. Okay, let's try to shoot this guy in the leg. 10886. And why that's happening, you can probably see that those explosive damage are really high. Yeah, that's true, those are really high. Because in case of energy weapons, explosion is carrying full damage of the gun. It's how I'm getting such a huge damage from those explosions. That's a remainder of the old system when all explosions were doing 100% of the weapon damage. Then it was basically explosive weapon was the double damage. That was a bullet hitting for full damage and explosion hitting for full damage. Then it was changed over a year ago, reduced to 20% damage, that is explosion, but this nerf didn't apply to legacy weapons. That's one of the reasons why everyone wants them. Everyone wants legacy weapons because they're doing such a huge damage. Now, just to prove the point about the Gauss I was showing you, let's shoot one of those super mutant in the head. I will need to use VATS to shoot him in the head with this gun, as it's not great sniper weapon. But look at that. See? 4 damage, nothing else. He took like no damage. And why that's happening? Because basically this gun is like 99% explosive. 99% of damage of the broadsider is the explosion, and like something like 1% is the impact damage. If I aim for the head with so little of the impact damage, I'm getting very little, close to zero damage, and explosion is too small to attach to the ground, therefore explosive damage is zero. And this gun then is doing zero damage if I shoot for the head, but it's working great if I shoot for the legs or for the torso. Cannot put suppressor on that, then I will not demonstrate more on this gun. We are going back to suppressed guns. Back to explosive pipe rifle, and now the topic of the VATS. As I said, VATS is different. VATS is different because for whatever reason, let's use this doggo, shoot on the torso, you see? 2 explosions. I don't know why, but whenever you shoot in VATS, explosion is calculated twice. I think it's calculated once inside the VATS, and once, normally, like you will hip fire outside of the VATS and you end up with 2 explosions applying simultaneously. And that's why explosive weapons are doing really good in VATS. But only if you hit them like in a torso or legs, as head is usually quite too far. And even if explosion can reach ground from the head, it's already reduced damage because of the distance. That's why those explosive weapons work so good on the torso. And that's another reason why 2-shot explosive weapons work so good in VATS. Because if we shoot in VATS, then we have a lot of damage numbers, everything is calculated. And that's why 2-shot explosive weapons are doing so well in VATS. If I shoot in VATS, I have those explosions twice, and I'm getting more damage than I will get if I will shoot outside of VATS. It's not 100% consistent, as those are 2 projectiles, multiple explosions and VATS calculation, then it's not always doing the same damage. Like this game, in case of applying a lot of calculations at one time, is getting very confused about what damage should be applied, and that's causing the damage to not be so consistent. But anyway, 2-shot explosive weapons in VATS are doing great, as there is a lot of explosions, and as I said, in case of 2-shot weapons, every explosion have a full power, and doubling it up with VATS does not hurt. What else you should know about the explosive effect? It is not affected by your sneak bonuses. That's one of the reasons those damage numbers are not even greater. not affected by sneak bonuses, not affected by headshots, because those are calculated separately by hitting the ground with explosion and counting the distance from when you hit with the bullet, then it's not a headshot for explosion purposes. Therefore, there's no headshots, no sneak stuff, no VATS criticals. Okay, I will show you VATS critical. Explosive pipe rifle, torso, 6 to 7, two explosions, yeah, but that's not a two shot. And now VATS critical, and still 6 to 7. Only the impact damage is multiplied by VATS critical, the explosion damage is not. Then explosive damage is not affected by a lot of bonus set. It is affected by demolition expert, and it is affected by weapon perks like rifleman and stuff like that, but not by special bonuses like VATS crit or by... Oh no, you can see me. Okay, I was forced to relocate. Then it's not affected by sneak or VATS criticals, but it is affected by regular perks, it is affected by armor penetration that you have equipped. And VATS is doubling it up for whatever reason. What else this is not affected by that is actually positive now? It's not affected by the range on the charge of the weapon. Like if you have charge up weapons like Gauss pistol, as every Gauss weapon is explosive, even though it's not stated anywhere on the weapon, it is explosive. And it is not affected, the explosive portion of the damage, it's not affected by charge of the weapon. Therefore, if you just tap the trigger or charge the weapon fully, explosion is always, let's say, fully charged. Then explosive always doing full damage regardless of that. What's important if you're using weapon like Gauss shotgun, as you can fire it quickly using invats for a torso and do very high damage. And this damage of those explosions will unfortunately not work if you aim for the head. That's the reason. If you have a Gauss shotgun, not the pistol I'm showing, I just don't have shotgun on this character. If you have Gauss shotgun and you aim for the head, you will notice that your damage is super low. That's because all those explosions that normally apply twice in VATS are not there. You need to aim for the torso or legs. The good thing is that all those explosions as well on normal weapons, explosive weapons, with exception of shotguns, like shotguns were nerfed in this regards as well, but any other weapon with explosive bullets, those explosions are not losing damage with the range. Regardless how far enemy is, explosive damage will be the same. Then it's not affected by VATS and sneak, but as well it's not affected by damage drop-off with a distance. Explosions have separate distance that is calculated like from point of impact to the ground. Unfortunately, as I said, shotguns for whatever reason were changed and explosion damage is losing power with a distance on shotguns only. Oh, I almost forgot. There is a perk that I'm getting questions all the time. There is a perk called Grenadier, and this perk does not affect weapons. It's not for weapons. It doesn't say anywhere in here. It only say your explosives detonate with twice the radius. What they mean by explosives, it's not the weapons. Those are not rocket launchers. Those are not grenade launchers. Those are not legacy. Those are not legendary effect on the weapons. Those are literally explosive like grenades or dynamite. This stuff is affected by this perk. Nothing else. Throwable explosive. Nothing else is affected by this perk. It will not help you to cover this distance to the head with Gauss weapons. As well, what are the implications? Explosive weapons are very weak versus flying targets like Scorch Beast, as those explosions are not applying correctly. They do sometimes work if you aim for the torso with something with huge explosion radius in VATS. Like if you use something like grenade launcher and you aim for Scorch Beast torso, even flying Scorch Beast will drop. I think it's some kind of a radius involving hitting all the parts of the Scorch Beast and VATS. I don't know exactly how this works, but it does do damage. And if you shoot with normal, legendary or even legacy explosive weapons, it's not happening. It's just you can see that damage is severely reduced. In case of Scorch Beast Queen, there is something else involved as well. Even if she's on the ground, she's so huge that most of the explosive effects will just not work. It's why like missile launchers, mini nukes and stuff like that can barely scratch Scorchbeast Queen. She's just too big for explosion to actually work properly. In case of Colossus, it's similar situation, but at least his legs are quite long and close to the ground. Then you can aim for legs and explosions will work. And now I think it's everything. It was a little bit of explaining. I hope I covered it well. I will still try to answer any questions in comment section, as there can be some. But that's the best what I can do at this moment. I hope you guys enjoyed that explanation. If you need to watch it twice, I do understand. This topic is very confusing, but I need to get it out as there is more and more questions about it. And now, as always, thank you a lot for watching and see you all in the next one.